I'm Ruby, and this is my dog, Bowie.
Hi, I'm Devon, and this is my dog, Violet.
Hi, I'm Lesley, and this is my dog, Darwin.
Dragons Love Tacos by Adam Rubin, illustrated by Daniel Salmieri. Hey, kid, did you know that dragons love tacos? They love beef tacos and chicken tacos. They love really big, gigantic tacos and tiny little baby tacos as well. Why do dragons love tacos? Maybe it's the smell from the sizzling pan. Maybe it's the crunch of the crispy tortillas. Maybe it's a secret. Either way, if you want to make friends with a dragon, tacos are key. Hey, dragon, why do you guys love tacos so much? But wait, as much as dragons love tacos, they hate spicy salsa even more. They hate spicy green salsa and spicy red salsa. They hate spicy chunky salsa and spicy smooth salsa. If the salsa is spicy at all, dragons can't stand it. Why do dragons hate spicy salsa? Well, just one drop of hot sauce makes a dragon's ears smoke. Just one single speck of hot pepper makes a dragon snort sparks. Spicy salsa gives dragons tummy troubles. And when dragons get the tummy troubles, oh boy. If you want to make tacos for dragons, keep the toppings mild. Tomatoes, lettuce, cheese, these are all good toppings for tacos for dragons. Hey, dragon. How do you feel about spicy taco toppings? Dragons love parties. They like costume parties and pool parties. They like big, gigantic parties with accordions and little tiny parties with charades. Why do dragons love parties? Maybe it's the conversation. Maybe it's the dancing. Maybe it's the comforting sound of a good friend's laughter. The only thing dragons love more than parties or tacos is taco parties. Taco parties are parties with lots of tacos. But okay, gonna take a break. I'm not sure you can cut this for your cut. Okay. 3, 2. If you want to have some dragons over for a taco party, you'll need buckets of tacos, pant loads of tacos. The best way to judge is to get a boat and fill the boat with tacos. That's about how many tacos dragons need for a taco party. After all, dragons love tacos. Hey, dragon, are you excited for the big taco party? Just remember, dragons hate spicy salsa. Before you host your taco party with the dragons, get rid of all the spicy salsa. In fact, bury the spicy salsa in the backyard so that the dragons can't find it. These dragons love your taco party. They love the music, they love the decorations, they especially love the tacos. Congratulations! It's a good thing that you got rid of all that spicy. Wait a second. What are those tiny little green things in the salsa? You didn't read the fine print? Totally mild salsa. Now with spicy jalapeno peppers. Dragons, listen to me. Do not eat those tacos. Those little green specks in the salsa, they're jalapeno peppers. They're super spicy. I know you love tacos, dragons, but you are not gonna love those tacos. Do not let those dragons eat those tacos. Crunch, crunch, crunch. too late. Why would the dragons help you rebuild your house? Maybe they're good Samaritans. Maybe they feel bad for wrecking it. Maybe they're just in it for the taco breaks. After all, dragons love tacos.
Good Night Stories for Rebel Girls by Elena Favilli and Francesca Cavallo. Simone Biles. Once there was a girl who could fly. Her name was Simone Biles. Simone Biles was a gymnast, the greatest in American history. When Simone took the mat, people couldn't take their eyes off her. She was so fast, so strong, so flexible, so agile. She flew through the air with such grace and speed, twisting and turning, landing perfectly each time. Simone started gymnastics when she was just 6 years old. By the time she was 18, she had already won many medals, that when she traveled to Rio for the Olympics, everyone expected her to not win one, but 5 medals. One day, a journalist asked her, "How do you deal with that kind of pressure?" "I try not to think about it. Right now, my goal is to be more consistent on the uneven bars." "What about the goal of winning a gold medal?" "A medal can't always be gold," Simone replied, smiling. "It's like my mom always says, if doing your best means you come out on top, that's awesome. If it means that you finish fourth, that's awesome too." Simone's mom adopted her when Simone was 3. She taught Simone that staying humble and doing your best is the best way to live a meaningful life and to inspire everyone around you. At the Olympics, Simone won 5 medals. 4 of them were gold.
Good night, Boston. Good morning, Boston Harbor and Lighthouse. Are we ready for a wonderful day? Good morning, Old Ironsides. Good morning, Boston Tea Party ship. You can do it, Boston Marathon runners. Hello, Boston Pops and Charles River. Listen to the music. Good afternoon, statue of Make Way for Ducklings. Good afternoon, swan boat. Go Red Sox, win the game at Fenway Park. Wow, look at the sea life at the New England Aquarium. It's nice to see you, students. Isn't it fun to learn together? Good evening, Boston Museum of Science. You can do it, New England Patriots. Go Celtics, go Bruins. Good night, Boston Museum of Fine Art. 99 buildings. Good night, Bostonians. Thank you for sharing a wonderful day.
Hi, I'm Maia, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make a magazine collage.
Hi, I'm Ruby, and I Today, I'm going to be showing you how to make a frozen lemonade.
Hi, I'm Devon, and I'm going to be showing you how to make a braid.
This is how you can make a magazine collage. So all you're going to need for this how-to is a magazine that you are allowed to cut. Make sure you check that with your parents. A glue stick, a Sharpie, some scissors, and any piece of paper that you want to be the back of your collage. For my piece of paper, I'm just going to be making a small collage today, so I'm just using this small square piece of paper. I like to use pattern pieces of paper because I think that they look cool on the back of the collage. So we're going to put these supplies to the side for now, and we're going to look at the magazine. So what I like to do is I like to pick a few colors that I want my collage to be based on. So let's say that I just want to do like light blue and white kind of colors. So I'll go through and I'll look for those kinds of colors in the magazine. So let's say here, the sky is pretty blue if you can't tell. So I'll just take my scissors and I'll cut out part of this page. And it doesn't have to be too big, of course, depending on what you're doing, how big your paper is. So here it is. I'm going to put this to the side for now. Now I'm going to go through and I'm going to find some more colored pieces of pictures. Now that I've cut out some pictures that I think are going to work, I'm going to go through and I'm going to try to find some small paragraphs or any places where there is text that has the same kind of colors. And if you really want to make your collage have a theme, you can read all of the text that you are thinking about putting in, and maybe you want it to be relate. Right now, I'm just going to pick some random text ideas, nothing that like really makes sense together, just so that it looks cool together. Here's a piece of text that is white, so I'm going to cut it out because it goes with my colors. Now I'm going to go through, and I usually like to put less text than pictures, so I'm only going to find about two or even three text boxes. Now that I've cut out all of my text boxes and my photos, I am going to kind of trim them so that all the sides are even. When you're cutting them out of the magazine, you don't have to worry too much about that as long as you do this step. So I'm just going to cut out all the jagged edges and maybe around the corners if I'd like. You also want to make sure that they'll be able to fit the paper, but don't worry about that too much just because we are going to be cutting the excess later. Okay, so I just finished evening everything out, and now I'm going to begin to glue things on. Of course, first you're going to want to start with the biggest pictures that you have. It's okay if they don't exactly fit your paper because, again, like I said, we are going to be trimming all the excess off. So I'm going to start with my biggest photo, and I'm going to take my glue stick and just put glue on most of the back because you don't really want it to come off of the paper because it might not stay as well and affect the other pictures. So here we go. I'm just going to put it where I want it on the paper. I'm just going to stick it down. Make sure that it's nice and smooth. Okay, now I'm going to do this with some more pictures and I'll be right back. So I've now glued down my three biggest photos. And now I'm going to move on to the text boxes. So I have three different boxes here. So I'm going to take the biggest one first, and I'm going to glue it where I want it. And now, of course, you can choose different photos, different amount of photos. Really, you can choose whatever you want. I'm just suggesting that you put the biggest photos down first, no matter what photos you have. Because that way, if you put down all the small ones, the big ones are just going to cover them up if you do them after. Okay, I'm going to finish gluing down my text boxes, and you can too. Okay, so I finished gluing down my text boxes, so I'm going to move on to my last two photos here. Now, when you're gluing, do take in mind that your pictures are going to be going off of your piece of paper. So be sure that you're not gluing anything directly off of your piece of paper, because otherwise you're going to cut it straight off when you're cutting off the excess. So here I am. I'm just going to be gluing on these last few photos and moving on to the final step. And when you're picking your colors that you want to have while you are doing this, make sure that they're colors that go together and that you like, because if it doesn't work out, it might just not look as professional or as good as it possibly can. Now, I like using these collages as birthday cards, as gifts, really as anything. I feel like they work so well for a lot of different things, and they're just perfect for almost any circumstance. Okay, so I have finished gluing down all of my photos and text boxes. So now I am going to move on to cutting off the excess. As you can see, there is a lot of excess on mine since I picked such a small piece of paper. So all you're going to do is you're going to take your scissors and you're just going to snip along the edge of the paper from the back. This way, just everything looks nice and neat and even, and it gives it a nice look. I'm just picking a small picture for this one, but I have made very large collages before, and you can too. I find those especially fun when they're so big, because you have so much that you can do and play with. Finally, the final step is you're going to take your Sharpie, and you don't have to just if you don't want to. You can just write a little message on this paper. So I'm just going to be writing mine. Okay. And you can add other decorations if you would like little stars or little polka dots. And there you go. You have your collage. Stay safe.
Hi. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make frozen lemonade. It's really good and really simple. So the only thing you're going to use for making is a blender, so get some parental supervision with that. So first thing you're going to add to your blender is I'm going to add, I have 2 cups of ice here that I'm just going to add in. And then I'm going to add in my 1/3 of lemon juice. I have 1/3 of water here. And I have 1/2 cup of sugar. And so you're just going to add that all into the blender, and then you'll blend. So see you after that. Okay, so now that I have my mix all blended, I just have a mason jar here, and I'm going to pour it in. So it's all nice and full. Then I am going to add straw and enjoy.
So today I'm going to be showing you how to make a braid. So the materials you will need is 3 pieces of string, any kind of string. They can be different colors, they can be the same color. I have this like rainbow colored one, so they're all different. And then you don't need tape. Like if you're doing it on hair, obviously you don't need tape, but if you're doing it like with string, then you would use tape. And the same method for this applies to hair too. So if you want to braid your hair, you can do it like that. It's the same way. So you're going to want to tape a piece of tape, be any kind of tape, as long as it can hold it down. So then you're going to put, see the 3 of them together? You're just going to want to tape it down to the floor, a table, whatever surface you're going to do it on. Because
if you don't, it'll, like, you'll have to tie a knot, and it's much easier just to do it like this. So how you're going to want to braid is you're going to want to take the one all the way, the one, like, all the way on this side. You're going to cross it here and then cross the other one. It's just a bunch of crisscrosses. So you're just going to keep crossing those, and then you can pull it. And you keep twisting those like that. So one over, then the other one over. And then you keep going like that. And it may not look so good at the top, but then you can just cut that top part out. But, and like, if you pull it, the tighter it will get and the stronger it will hold. But when you're doing it, you want to make sure the end that you're not doing it with doesn't get super twisted up, because that will happen and it will mess it up. And then you'll have to, like, start over, and it'll be really annoying. So you just keep doing that twist, the this one over, so the review, and then the other one over, and then the middle one, and then the middle one becomes the one over here. See how it got all twisted up? You want to make sure you keep them in place while you do that. And that's how you do a braid. Kind of see, that's how it turned out. And then if you want to turn it into a bracelet, mine's really long to make a bracelet, but then you can just tie it up here or where, however you do it so that it would fit. And then you just tie it. Then you have a bracelet. It's kind of hard to see. And they have a bracelet, but if yours is really long like mine, I would cut it in the spots that you would want it to so that you can tie it to make the bracelet. And it's the same way applies for your hair, but just at the end, you'll put like a hair tie right here and tie it, and then there'll be like a little extra there. That's how it works for hair. It's the same thing for both. And yeah. So, yeah. Screen.